Assalamu alaikum. How are you, my dear students? I think you are all well. I am also fine by the grace of Allah Almighty. My dear student, I think you are all well by the grace of Allah Almighty. I, Muhammad Nurul Alam, a senior teacher of Milestone School and College, English Medium Senior Section, Sector 11. My dear viewers, today I am going to discuss such topics. First, I have to tell a story. Then you will guess which topics we are going to discuss today. My dear viewers, one boy named Nabil, he used to tell lies, vulgar words, shameful words also. On the other hand, he used to take away something from others without his or her knowledge. Can you guess what types of topics today we are going to discuss? My dear viewers, I think you have already guessed, identified which topics we are going to discuss. Today, I am going to discuss Akhlaq-e-Zamima. Here in Akhlaq-e-Zamima, we will get two lessons here, indecency and theft. Let's go by showing a chart paper. I am telling you what types of topics I am coming to discuss today. My dear viewers, after learning these topics, we will come to learn some important teaching points. First, I am telling my dear student, follow. After learning this lessons, we learn about Akhlaq-e-Zamima. What are indecency and theft? Bad effects of indecency and theft. Prevention of indecency and theft. And Arabic term of indecency and theft. My dear viewers, telling you the teaching point. Today I am teaching you what types of topics. First, see on the chart paper. First on, we know Akhlaq. Akhlaq means character. There are two types of Akhlaq. Akhlaq-e-Hamida and Akhlaq-e-Zamima. You see here, Akhlaq-e-Zamima. Akhlaq means character and Zamima means bad, detestable. My dear viewers, you see, Akhlaq-e-Zamima means bad or detestable character. Here, I am telling the definition of Akhlaq-e-Zamima. My dear student, follow. Akhlaq-e-Zamima, the character of a person. Listen properly, my dear viewers. The character of a person as reflected in his or her daily activities, which make him or her narrow-minded and hateful, are called Akhlaq-e-Zamima. My dear student, for your better understanding, I am telling again, Akhlaq-e-Zamima. द कैरेक्टर ऑफ ए पर्सन एज रिफ्लेक्टेड इन हीज और हर डेली एक्टिविटीज व्हिच मेक हिम और हर नैरो माइंडेड एंड हेटफुल आर कॉल्ड अखलाक जमीमा। माई डियर व्यूअर्स, आई थिंक यू हैव अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट अखलाक जमीमा। इन अखलाक जमीमा टू टॉपिक्स आई एम कमिंग टू डिस्कस, नंबर वन इनडिसेंसी एंड अनदर वन थेट। लुक एट द बोर्ड एंड सी। फर्स्ट ऑन इनडिसेंसी, माई डियर व्यूअर्स फॉलो इनडिसेंसी। द अरेबिक टर्म ऑफ इनडिसेंसी अल बजातु, अगेन अरेबिक टर्म ऑफ इनडिसेंसी अल बजातु। हियर ऑफ सी अरेबिक पार्ट आई हैव रिटन अल बजातु, अलिफ लाम जबर अल बा जबर बा जल जबर जा जल अलिफ जबर जा आइन जबर आ तापेश्तु अल बजातु। माई डियर व्यूअर्स, फॉर योर बेटर अंडरस्टैंडिंग आई एम शोइंग हियर ऑल्सो अरेबिक टर्म, बिकॉज समटाइम्स यू विल फेस दिस टाइप्स ऑफ क्वेश्चन इन डिफरेंट एग्जाम। नाउ मीनिंग्स ऑफ इनडिसेंसी, आई वॉन्ट टू शो यू अगेन इनडिसेंसी, इट्स अरेबिक टर्म अल बजातु। आई हैव रिटन हियर इंग्लिश वर्ड एंड ऑल्सो अरेबिक वर्ड ऑल्सो। मीनिंग्स, hues of meanings will get about indecency. Now indecency, it means incivility, shamelessness activities. Here we can add it another meanings also. Indecency refers to heinous acts, incivility, shamelessness and unlawful sexual desire. My dear viewers, the meanings of indecency, all kind of bad language, vulgar word, shamelessness activities or shamelessness words or speech, in a word all kind of bad language including indecency. Now I'm coming to tell you about definition. My dear viewers, look at the chart paper and follow. Definition of indecency: all the evil deeds, shameful activities, vulgar speeches and attitude done openly or secretly without any hesitation are called indecency. My dear viewers, I am telling the definition again. What is indecency? All the evil deeds, shameful activities, vulgar speeches and attitudes done openly or secretly without any hesitation are called indecency. My dear student, for your better understanding, I have given you few example like that, someone telling bad language against other, bad comments against other. Not only that, someone shows other the different kind of attitude by using or you're symboling different kinds of sexual desire, including these are called indecency in Arabic al-bajatu. My dear viewers, now I'm telling you about the bad effects of indecency. What kind of problem we will face if you follow these types of things? See, for here, my dear student, first, bad effects of indecency. I have found here few bad effect. I am telling you here point wise and discussion. First, see,
a great guy. Indecency, it is one kind of social crime. If anyone did these types of activities, he faced different kind of social problem. Now, it is also called a great crime because if anyone don't keep himself or herself away from indecency or indecent activities, indecent word, he or she face different kind of problems in society. Second one, see, hampering peace and discipline. Also, he or she will face different kind of social peace and discipline. He never or she never keep in their mind peace and discipline because nobody will love them, nobody will cooperate them. For that reason, everyone will face different kind of problems. They don't face peace and discipline situation in the society. Not only that, let's go third number point. Here, people and society. That means in the society or at the time the people, that means they are corrupting the people and society. That means if anyone involved in indecency or indecent activities, they involve corrupting the people and society, because when they will tell any word, they did not keep balance with their word, with their activities. At that time, the people will not love them. Instead of loving them, people will hate them. My dear viewers, that's why we must keep away from indecent activities from our daily activities. If you want to get the love of others, we have to follow the decent word and give up all kind of indecent activities. My dear student, let's go point number four. Here also, fourth point, involving in evil activities. Who will use to different kind of indecent activities, speeches, word, they will involve themselves in different kind of bad activities, evil activities. My dear student, point number five, indecency as unlawful act. See, that means all kind of indecency activities, it is unlawful act. It is not lawful because about it Allah Almighty said, say, my Lord has forbidden all indecent practices, either open or secret. Surah Al-Araf, verses number 33. My dear viewers, see, about unlawful activities, indecent activities, Allah Almighty said, Surah Al-Araf, verses number 33, to keep away, to give up all kind of indecent activities. Not only that, but also Allah also said, stay away from all evil activities, whether open or secret. My dear viewers, all kind of evil or indecent activities, we have to keep away ourselves. Allah also insists us in Surah Anam, verses number 151. My dear student, for your better understanding, I mentioned here two ayat from the Holy Quran to keep away ourselves from all kind of unlawful activities. My dear students, see, sixth number point, indecent behavior is hated by all in the society. all kind of people will hate. I think whose behavior is indecent, not decent. My dear viewers, about it, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the indecency of a person makes him imperfect. He who has the sense of modesty attains beauty and grace. The hadith has been taken from the famous hadith kitab Tirmizi. For your better understanding, I am telling again, my dear student, follow. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said again, the indecency of a person makes him imperfect. He who has the sense of modesty attains beauty and grace. That means we always keep ourselves away from indecent behavior, indecent activities, and all kind of bad deeds. And last number point, the bad effects of indecency, the doors of paradise are closed. It is very sad for the people who will involve themselves in all kind of indecent activities in indecency. About it, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the door of paradise are closed. Who will involve themselves in all kind of indecent activities? For all doers of indecent practices, the doors of paradise are closed. For your better understanding, I am telling my dear viewers, if anyone involve any kind of bad deeds or evil activities or vulgar word, for them Allah Almighty closed the door of paradise. It is said our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, if we want to save ourselves from indecent activities, few points I have mentioned here, I think if you want to follow, you can keep yourself from all kind of indecent activities. Now look at the chart paper and see. Prevention from indecency. See, my dear student, prevention from indecency. If you want to keep away yourself from indecent activities, you have to follow first to obey the principles and ideals of Islam. See, my dear student, all kind of principles and ideals of Islam you have to follow to keep away yourself from all kind of indecent activities. Islam told us what to do and not to do. We must follow that. Then we can keep away ourselves from all kind of indecent activities. Point number two, my dear student, to raise familiarness. It is another important point to keep away ourselves from all kind of indecent activities. Familiarness from the family life, that means when we were little baby, step by step or gradually we are coming off from the family. If we get the moral lesson or the family awareness, we may keep ourselves from all kind of indecent activities. Second undone. Now let's go third number, to raise social awareness. Also, in which society we are growing up, it is also a kind of fact, it is a kind of matter. If you want to keep away ourselves from all kind of indecent activities, that's why you should select your society. I think it will be good and it will be better for you. And four number, after getting this types 3 point, fourth number point, after that, if anyone did not keep himself or herself from indecent activities for him or her to give exemplary punishment by lawful prevention. That means if anyone involved any kind of indecent activities, after getting these types of warning, he or she has to give some punishment so that nobody dare to do again these types of activities again. My dear student, after this point I completed about the prevention from indecency. I expect you will follow this point and try to obey your daily activities. You will keep yourself from all kind of evil or indecent activities. Another point I am mentioned here, look at the chart paper, theft. Here another point, theft, Arabic term of theft, my dear viewers, see, I have written here Arabic, also English also, as-sarakatu. See again, the Arabic term of theft, as-sarakatu. Here also I have written Arabic, as-sarakatu, alif, lam, sin, ra, kaf, ta. That means as-sarakatu. My dear viewers and my dear students, see, alif, sin zabar as, sin zabar sa, ra zabar ra, kaf zabar ka, ta peshto, as-sarakatu. I think you have learned what is the Arabic term of theft. I am telling again, as-sarakatu. For your better understanding, I am telling several times. Because sometimes you may get these types of question in your exam. Meanings of theft. I have mentioned two meanings, but you will get a use of meanings. Look at the board, my dear student. Theft, it means to steal, to sinners. To steal, to sinners. My dear student, I am telling you again meanings of theft, to steal or stealing, to steal or stealing or to snatch, or sometimes we can mention kidnap also. Kidnap also you also mention from here. My dear student, see and look at the chart paper again. I want to mention the definition of theft. Look at the board here. When someone takes away other's property or things secretly without the owner's knowledge, it is called theft. For your better understanding, I am telling again. When someone takes away others' property or things secretly without the owner's knowledge, it is called theft. My dear viewers, I think you have understood what is called theft, meanings of theft, Arabic term of thefts. Now, I am telling you the bad effect of theft. See, I have mentioned here 5 points only. I am discussing one by one. First on C. Due to theft in our society, totally feel insecurity. First point, insecurity. When we will get any kind of theft in our society, we will feel insecurity. For theft, wealth and life become subject to insecurity. Sometimes the theft even murders the owners without the fear of being caught. That means insecurity also, but sometimes the theft murder the owners. Second point, destruction of social peace. My dear student, follow. Destruction of social peace. People cannot sleep peacefully. My dear student, follow. People cannot sleep peacefully because of theft. They are to keep account for the safety for their property. द सोशल पीस एंड रिलीफ आर डिस्टर्ब मच बिकॉज ऑफ द फियर ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी बीइंग स्टॉलन. That's why in the society the people can't sleep because their valuable property may be stolen. That's why social peace will be destruction. Third number point, increasing social crime. My dear student, follow. Due to theft, social crime will increase. See here. In the society, new crimes are committed because of theft. A thief does not become satisfied when he only stealing, rather he tends to snatch, kidnap, murder, and sometimes disgrace women also. That's why increasing social crime due to theft. Point number four, stealing is a hateful deed also. My dear viewers, stealing also it is hateful activities. Every people hate who will steal. See, theft is all of the detestable crimes in the society. People consider a thief hateful in the society and feel ashamed of his being relative. Both family and society hate him. My dear student, if anyone steal, due to his or her stealing, his family member did not show their face to their relatives because one of his or her relative is still from others. And five number point, punishment in the life after death. My dear student, here and hereafter, that means in the earthly life and day after life, both place the thief will get punishment. Theft is an heinous activities and forbidden deeds. It cannot make a person a true mu'min. Allah has promised to punish him severely in afterlife. That means when he will die or she will die after his death, Allah will give him severe punishment. My dear student and my dear viewers, I want to tell you, those who have this habit, I think you have to keep away yourself from these types of habit. Now, I am telling you about the prevention from theft. If we want to keep away ourselves, we have to keep away ourselves this kind of bad deeds or akhlaq zamima. First one, fulfillment of basic needs. My dear student, follow. Fulfillment of basic needs. Why a person wants to steal? We have to find out the causes. Because if he or she want to thief due to his wants of food, clothes, or he or she has no any kind of job, that's why he or she is stealing. I want to tell you, my dear viewers, for that reason, give them the proper needs, and it is better to give them different kind of facilities to involve job. Then they may keep themselves away for stealing. Two number point, arrangement for exemplary punishment. After giving all kind of facilities, if they don't keep away themselves, give them the sense of punishment. About the punishment, Allah Almighty said in the Holy Quran, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Assariq wa Assariqatu फक्तौ आइदुहुमा जजरम बिमा कसबा नकलम मिनल्लाह। अल्लाह सेड इन द होली कुरान सूरह अल माईदा वर्सेस नंबर 38, काट देयर हैंड्स ऑफ व्हेदर दे आर मेन और वुमेन। For Allah, it is the exemplary punishment for what they have committed. My dear viewers, after that, if nobody keep out themselves from getting all kind of facilities, give them punishment according to the order of Allah Almighty to cut their hands off. Third number point, moral awareness. To keep away the people from stealing their moral awareness, that means they must be grown up in proper morality and proper way, then they may keep away themselves to steal. And last number point, religious teaching. From the very beginning of their life, give them religious teaching. Give them religious teaching. For your better understanding, I tell you, my dear viewers, for your all kind of betterment, you need to take religious teaching so that you can get all kind of things properly. My dear student, after learning this four, that means points for prevention of theft, I think you will keep yourself from all kind of indecent activities like theft, stealing, also like this types of bad deeds also. My dear viewers, I am telling you some important point about theft and indecency. After learning this point, we can learn the Arabic term of indecency and theft. I think you have learned already. Indecency al-bajatu, theft as-sarakatu. Second term, meanings of indecency and theft. Meanings of indecency and theft, you already got it. Third one, for all doors of indecency, for the doors of the paradise of indecency totally closed. Number four, we also learn indecency is a great crime. And I am telling you for your better understanding, for the punishment of a thief, keep in your mind always, and after keeping it in your mind, you keep you away from all kind of deeds. Keep you away from all kind of punishment, because if anyone is still, his or her hand will cut off. My dear viewers, after that, today from our online class, we will get homework number 2. It will learn plus write. See, I have made 2 questions. These 2 questions you will write in your homework copy mentioning online homework number 2. First one, write about the bad effects of indecency. I have already mentioned you 7 points. According to the points, you will explain. And second one, how can we prevent theft? Explain in detail. If you want to prevent theft, how you will prevent, explain these 2 questions you will write in your homework copy by mentioning homework number 2. No more today. Thank you all. Allah Hafiz, all of you. Pray for me. I also pray for you. Best luck. See you. Allah Hafiz.